that? Why is it crucial to claim and optimize your Google My Business page? And
sure.
And talk in sense of beginner's words, so people that are beginners and don't even know about this can understand.
Right.
Okay, go ahead.
Well, it's all about helpfulness. It's all about making sure that when somebody is performing a search and they're not specifically looking for your company, that you're providing as much helpful information as you possibly can. It's going to help them with their decision-making process. It's going to help them with trust, right, to make sure that they can trust your brand based on reviews and sentiments. It's also going to give them enough information to decide if it's right for them based on the variety of products and services you offer, based on your hours of operation. You know, all those different attributes play a role in whether they're going to show up to your location or not. So in every test that we've ran, the more of the fields that you fill out, not just Google My Business, even though we know that's the number one place people are going now, even more than Yelp in some cases, the more you fill out all the available fields, the more you log in and add more helpful pictures and videos, the higher the pages seem to rank. Especially if you're active, if you actively get on each of those different profiles on Yelp, on Google My Business, and you're just constantly adding new owner verified pictures, and you're constantly, you know, updating hours of operation and sharing posts of what's going on and what's new, answering questions that people have in the questions and answer section, and you're just actively engaged. The more actively engaged you are on each of those platforms, the more traffic you're going to get and the higher you're going to perform in their search results for some of those non-branded search terms. The claiming part's kind of a no-brainer. If you don't claim it, your competitor might, right? So you want to get in there and just make sure that you've done it. And sometimes you can just do it with a phone call. Other times they'll send you a postcard. It's not rocket science to do, but if you haven't claimed your business, please jump in there, hit that little, you know, claim this listing, you know, in the little knowledge panel for your business, and make sure that you do own it. But yeah, using all the available fields. Now here's something a lot of what I notice small businesses not doing. They're not looking at what's working for the competition. They're not looking at what competitors are using, what categories they've selected, you know, to put their brand under. Am I an American restaurant or am I a bar and grill? Right? Really take a look at who your top competitors are in the areas that you want to be in. Look at which search terms are the ones that are most important to your business, you know, and then start to build out your profile. Don't just go in there and start writing some things. Do some research. Do some searches. Look at the map results and see who shows up the most prominently. Maybe even choose a few other cities that you're not in to see what the folks who are ranking in those areas are doing. Spend some time, really reverse engineer, not just the fields that they use on their Google My Business and on their Yelp profiles, but look at their website, look at the page that they're sending users to, look at the content that's on those pages and ask yourself, is my content as helpful and as detailed and as comprehensive as this page or these other 10 results that appear on page one where I'm not yet?
Great advice. What's your opinion on the service area? It's your opinion, for example, I talk to a lot of my clients, they're like, oh, no, we can service here, there. And I always, my advice to them is just choose four surrounding cities and go with that and not just Orange County. Don't just choose Orange. What are your thoughts on that?
I think a lot of it's testing. But for the most part, if you're a service area business only and they don't come to your location, then yeah, you'll want to choose those areas that are the most important to you, that are closest to where your location is, because proximity is still going to beat you no matter what you put, no matter how much you try to hack the algorithm. Proximity to where, you know, the visitor is always going to be number one. So if you're just on the outskirts of a major city and you're trying to rank for the major city, probably not going to happen, right? Unless you actually get a satellite location in the actual city. Yeah, no worries. We were talking about Google My Business fields and, you know, trying to make sure that we're using all the fields that are available. Being active in those profiles can make such a difference. So, I think there's, you know, we mentioned the four parts of a local search strategy: making sure your data is accurate and the data that's being used by directories is accurate by getting into what they call aggregators, the Foursquare and Neustar, Localese, and Data Axle. And you can do that, you know, through bulk providers like Moz Local and Bright Local. They offer the service for like $150 a year, and they manage your business data for you for the accuracy. And you're mentioning about the proximity issue. If you are on the outskirts of a city how do I, you know, really try to dominate in that city, it's going to be tough because of the proximity factor. So if I were a brick and mortar where they come to my location, my effort would be focused on maybe a 5 mile radius or less for Google Maps. For organic, on the other hand, I can create organic content to show up, you know, and wherever I want to. Just put the, you know, the like a page together that describes and list some of the clients that come in from the cities that you serve. So you might not be able to own every city in the map pack, but you could still make sure that you have visibility in every city and the organic results below the maps by creating content on your website. So we have an attorney who does car accident cases, and he created a car accident page for each of the cities that he targets where he has customers. And the customer's review will be on there, a video. It says, hi, this is, you know, Joe, attorney, Anderson's car accident lawyer. You know, like have you watch a quick customer testimonial from a client we had in Anderson, and we're going to talk about some of the things to avoid in getting accidents in Anderson, and some resources of things in Anderson that will help you if you are in a car accident. And so he creates a really helpful page for every single city that he wants to target, and he's usually in the top three organic search results below the map for every single city in all three practice areas that he's targeting, and it works. But right. You've got to take the time and build that out, and it took him almost a year to do it. So, right. But now he gets over 10,000 visits a month, and he's in a small state on the East Coast.
You know what's interesting, Steve? You know what I'm noticing? Google My Business is picking up words from your website and showing it as snippets inside the three-pack. Mm-hmm. So it says their website
mentions
Italian catering. So what is up with that?
That's awesome. That's what we want. Well, this was something that started after the Pigeon update. Years and years ago, Pigeon update was supposed to take more organic signals as opposed to just proximity and data visibility. You know, this idea of getting our business in all the different directories, you know, hey, I'm in 1,000 directories, so I'm going to be number one. That signal's gone away, and it's starting to use, well, it's there, it's just not nearly as prominent. And they're starting to use more organic signals, such as your page content, such as, you know, because I mentioned that whole entity idea. Now, it's not just a domain name. It's an actual brand entity with an entity ID in their database. So the more they find around, and they've already associated your primary domain with your entity, so they know when somebody searches for your name explicitly, you get the beautiful little listing at the top with search site links underneath it, because they know that that's the domain that corresponds to the entity. So if somebody is performing a search, of course, they're going to know, you know, what words associate with your entity because your domain's already associated with it. So I think from that standpoint, like I mentioned, try to have a page for each of the different services that you offer and be detailed and descriptive and use some of that user-generated content. Don't give Google and Yelp all those great reviews. Use them for yourself. They're already, like you said, going to pull that from the page. Organically, you know, the passages update that just happened recently now, they stopped measuring, you know, keyword relevancy based on the page relevancy. Now they're doing it based on a section of the page or a passage. So much opportunity for your pages to show up in search results and to influence your map rankings, because now they are using more organic signals and less of those, you know, very specific local signals.